We talked about the when of adaptive design, specifically choosing breakpoints and using resource qualifiers like W600DP. And we also touched on what we want to fix at these breakpoints. Let's now get into the how of implementing adaptive design on Android. Now, the simplest way to adapt your UI is to create a separate layout in Res Layout W600DP. You'll probably end up copying and pasting a bunch of layout XML code because your layouts probably won't be completely different. For example, here you can see the basic layout is a top bar with a collection below it, and it's the same in this tablet layout. This approach of simply copying and pasting will quickly lead to a maintenance problem with your code, where you'll need to make the same changes in lots of different layout XML files. Now, you could instead just vary a subsection of the layout using layout includes. Layout includes are basically a way of saying, hey, right here at this point in my layout, insert the contents of this other layout. In this example, the list view portion of the UI is in an include. The nice thing is that the container layout and the included layout can each vary individually using resource qualifiers. So in this code, we're saying when the width of the screen is over 600dp, change the included layout to this one. That layout can be better optimized for tablets, such as using a grid instead of a list.